Oh, really? A preview and first image of James Webb Space Telescope was released during a press conference at the White House.
That's right. So here to talk about it this morning, Kansas City's NASA Ambassador Danielle Jones. Thanks so much for joining us once again, Danielle, for making sense of this and helping us understand what we're looking at that everyone's so excited about.
I know. It's so exciting. Yeah, yesterday we released the first preview image. The preview image is exactly the same field that Hubble took, except for when you put it next to Hubble's picture, you can see how much better it is, 100 times better, in fact. So what you're looking at, right now you're looking at James Webb in its entirety before they launched it. The picture that they released yesterday, every bit of light that you see is a galaxy, so thousands and thousands and thousands of galaxies all in one picture. And we're looking back about 13.4 billion years.
Wow.
With the way that light travels about 5.8 trillion miles a year, you can kind of assert that we're looking at basically the beginning of the universe. We got a little bit of a gap. 13.8 billion is how old our universe is. So we have a window into the beginning of the Big Bang.
That is just insane to think about. So what can we look forward to for today's press conference?
So they guard it even from us, exactly what they're going to do. My assumption is that they may take similar pictures to what Hubble took, or looking at similar things so you can see the contrast and we can kind of show how powerful it is. Mm-hmm. Most of the pictures that we have, the really HD amazing pictures that you have for posters and screensavers and things, are Hubble. You know, we have the Pillars of Creation. That's a very famous picture. So my guess is that we're going to see the difference between the two. I don't know. I mean, the options are endless. We're going to be able to see exoplanets up close. So planets that are not in our solar system, planets that we think may have the capability of life. And we're going to be able to tell and be able to analyze them chemically to see if life could or does exist there.
Wow. Well, see, that was my next question. You beat me to the punch there, Danielle. So if somebody was just kind of skeptical of this whole thing and just sort of poo-pooing all the excitement.
I'm used to that.
they were to say, well, so what? What are we going to do with all this knowledge?
Right. Well, and I mean, I think not only for leaps and bounds for science, but NASA foundationally has discovered and made everybody's lives so much better and easier from missions like this. And yes, the images are great, and there is a quantifiable value to human hope and innovation and wonder. You know, turning on Facebook and seeing people who I didn't even know cared about space post that picture yesterday and get so excited about it almost made me emotional, because obviously I live in this. But I don't know the practical applications, but I'm hoping that we develop some new technology to be able to chemically analyze planets and things, so we can kind of see what things are made of.
Right.
That picture alone, you're looking at, I mean, like I said, thousands of galaxies. The ones that are red are the ones that are furthest back in our universe. And so thinking of, you know, that has outlived generations and whole, you know, human civilizations. Pretty incredible.
It's like older than the dinosaurs.
Yeah, and today, much, 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 much older. And today at 9:30, we're going to release some other images. And after that, basically, once the images get processed, they're going to be put right up on NASA's website. So the public's going to get instant access to them.
Man.
So, yep. And if you follow me at Casey's NASA Lady on Instagram, I'm going to try and circumvent their live stream, or at least kind of post some stuff and keep engaged.
All right. Man.